Governor Greg Abbott's executive order started overnight. It requires Texans to stay at home for the rest of the month unless they're accessing essential services and businesses. Governor Abbott joins us live this afternoon to talk more about what the state is doing to slow the spread of the new coronavirus. Governor, I know this is a very busy time for you. Thank you for joining us and taking the time to be here.
It is my pleasure. Thank you.
All right. So this new order, how will it help?
What this does is it ensures that we're urging people, if you're not involved in the essential functions of government in the state of Texas, or let's say for the city of Austin, you need to be at home. You need to be off the streets. I will tell you this, and that is, I've seen as I travel across Austin, like coming to this interview, there are too many people who are out right now who are not abiding by either the law or the spirit of the necessity of staying home. Let me tell you why this is so important. We have to stop the spread of the coronavirus. Here are the simple numbers from 1 week ago to today. 1 week ago, there were 1,400 people who tested positive for COVID-19. Today, that number has tripled to 4,650. A week ago, there were 18 deaths in Texas. Today, there are 70 deaths in Texas. Those numbers are going to increase. If you are not staying at home, you are contributing to the spread of the coronavirus in Texas, and you may be contracting it yourself. You're putting your own life in danger. You have the individual ability to stop the spread and to protect yourself from contracting this disease. The best way you can do that is to stay home.
All right, Governor, the language in your executive order, it is very similar to stay-at-home orders that were already put in place in many cities and counties across the Lone Star State, including here in Austin, but you stopped short of calling it that. Can you explain why?
Sure. I wanted to be, if you would, more precise about exactly what it calls for. You are correct when you suggest that it is similar to stay-at-home policies, whether they be in Austin or other jurisdictions. Construe a stay at home, meaning you cannot leave home. But under the Austin standard, of course, you could leave home to go to the store or to exercise, things like that, as long as you are maintaining distancing practices that don't transmit the coronavirus. So what I did, I was, in my opinion, just more precise, and that is saying that stay at home, with the exception of essential services, of running government and allowing you to access things like food that you need to be able to live and survive. Bottom line, it achieves the same concept, and that is, unless you have to be outdoors for any reason whatsoever to survive, such as getting groceries, you need to be at home.
That's an important thing for many Texans to know. Now, earlier this week, we learned that nearly four dozen UT students tested positive for COVID-19. This was all after they returned from a spring break trip to Cabo. When you found out about that, what was the first thing that went through your head?
I was very frustrated because we've been working so hard as a state, as a community, to try to reduce the spread, only to see now not only these students having it, but when they return back, whether it be on the flight or when they return home, et cetera, they have been spreading the coronavirus either in their families or in their friends or other circles. And so it's just going to increase the number of people in this area who test positive. So it's very frustrating, but once again, it dovetails into our warning. And that is, the United States of America has entered into an agreement with Mexico, for example, that prohibits cross-border traveling whatsoever, with the exception of commercial activity or other essential activity. So further trips like that are completely prohibited. We want to avoid importing COVID-19 into the state of Texas, which is exactly why I put the ban on travel from some of these hot zones in other parts of the United States of America. It's why, as we speak today, right now, I have the Texas Department of Public Safety patrolling the highways where people would be trying to drive in from Louisiana to Texas, so we can stop those people from coming into Texas.
Governor, last week during a Fox News interview, Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick suggested that he and other people his age would be willing to risk their health to help improve the economy. What was your reaction to that comment?
Well, as you may have seen when he joined with me the other day for my announcement of this new executive order, he stepped up and agreed precisely with what my standards are, and that is putting public health and safety first of all Texans. Listen, we want to do all we can as Texans, as leaders in this state, to make sure we reduce the number of people who contract COVID-19 and we reduce the deaths that could occur. We're all in this together, and we must focus for the remainder of the month of April to ensure that we reduce the spread of COVID-19. The way to do that is for people to stay at home unless you are engaged in an essential service.
As you said, we are all in this together, but this has been devastating for so many people. Hundreds of thousands of Texans have filed unemployment claims. We've reported that the Texas Workforce Commission is struggling to handle this surge. What is your office doing to help?
We are improving on a daily basis. That there has been a record amount of people who are applying for unemployment claims, and it's been massive, enormous. And so we brought in hundreds of new employees, whether they were new hires or reassigned from other agencies, to make sure that we would be able to respond to the high demand for these unemployment claims. Let me give your audience a couple of good pieces of news. One is we are processing these claims faster. Two, just because you may not have had your unemployment benefit claim approved yet doesn't mean you will be denied that. But maybe most importantly, when you look at all of the additional funding that has come from the federal government for unemployment claims, the claims reimbursements or payments that you will be getting are going to increase and especially extend in time. So you will be getting more benefits than what you were anticipating getting before. So just keep calling, keep trying to get in. Your claim will be responded to as soon as possible, and you will be getting your benefits.
All right, Governor, again, I know you are very busy. I appreciate you taking the time to join us on KXAN News at noon. I'm sending you a very sanitized handshake through the camera here.
There you go.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Well, one of the big differences between Governor Abbott's request for everyone to stay home and other executive orders like that is that churches are deemed essential. Governor Abbott said he wants to encourage churches to continue providing services online. But he adds if they have to meet, they should follow the federal guidance, which right now restricts gatherings of 10 or more people here at home. Neither Austin nor Travis or Williamson counties deemed churches as essential. Two pastors we spoke to say this is a time to realize as much as we want to be together, just now is not the time.
Format is different. The message is the same. Even though the remote sort of experience is less than ideal for us, I think it is the honorable thing to do.
This is our chance to care about others more than our own freedoms. You know, we have freedoms, but we can also use those freedoms in a way that causes harm to others, or we can limit our freedoms out of love for others.
They say they will continue to be there for their community virtually and do not have plans to meet in person. You know, with most states on lockdown, the last thing we want to think about right now is hurricanes. But the 2020 hurricane forecast is out. Up next, how many named storms they expect the U.S. to get this year, and how many of those could be major hurricanes. Plus, still to come, what you need to do now to make sure you get your stimulus check as fast as possible.
Hey there, everyone. Will Dupree once again in the KXAN Live studio. We've been listening into our new newscast with anchor Amanda Dugan. She just wrapped up her interview with Governor Greg Abbott. He joined us live by satellite answering some questions about some different topics. And we will post a full story recounting what he said on our website, KXAN.com. You can also check out that story on the KXAN News app. Before we take down this stream, after we listened into the governor's interview, I want to share a few updates we've gotten into our newsroom here this morning. First of all, Capital Metro, the public transit service here in the Austin area, has announced that four employees have now tested positive for COVID-19. If you take a look at this full screen really quickly, this is the information that we have at the moment. Capital Metro says that three bus operators and one mechanic tested positive for the virus. The buses driven by those three operators have now been taken out of service, and all four employees are now in self-isolation. I want to pull up and read some of the press release that Capital Metro sent out this morning, alerting everyone to this bit of information. And I'm going to keep this full screen up as I'm reading so that we have a little bit of context about what's been saying. Capital Metro was made aware this week that 4 of its staff members have tested positive for COVID-19. The agency will not release the names or medical updates for these employees, which are 3 bus drivers and a mechanic. Capital Metro strives to be transparent in our communication with our employees, customers, and community, especially during times like these. We are doing our best to provide information about which routes and dates our operators worked so that customers can proactively monitor their own health. In addition, we have taken proactive measures over the past weeks that minimize contact between our operators and customers. Now, here's some more information about these 4 employees. Capital Metro says in its press release, the mechanic works in our bus maintenance area and does not interact with the public. That person's last appearance at work was on March 16th. The first bus operator that confirmed a positive test last worked, on March 25th. That person drove Route 300 on the following days, March 19th, March 23rd, March 24th, and the 25th. The second bus operator's last day on the job was March 26th, and that person drove Route 383 on March 21st and Route 937 on March 23rd through the 26th. The fourth employee is also a bus operator whose last day driving was March 26th. The bus operator drove Route 985 on March 19th, Route 383 on March 22nd and 23rd, Route 325 on March 24th and 25th, and Route 335 on March 26th. Capital Metro is saying, according to its press release, anyone who has ridden these routes driven by these operators in the last 14 days should monitor themselves and contact their healthcare provider if they develop any symptoms. The buses driven by these operators have been temporarily removed from service for additional sanitation. Capital Metro started enhancing cleaning measures early in the COVID-19 emergency by applying a disinfectant to common hand contact areas, including poles, handrails, armrests, door handles, and stop request buttons throughout the day. On March 18th, we also implemented rear door boarding to encourage social distancing on our vehicles. Additionally, we have suspended all fares for the entire month of April. To keep customers and operators safe, we continue to monitor vehicle capacity to avoid overcrowding. Thank you all for bearing with me as I was just reading through that press release sent out by Capital Metro, but we wanted to share the most accurate information that that agency is providing at this point. As you saw on your screen there, 4 employees have tested positive for COVID-19, including 3 bus drivers and 1 mechanic who was not working directly with the public. All of that information that I just read aloud, we weren't able to put it in a full graphic so that you could see for yourself. However, it's all listed on our website, kxan.com, at the moment, so please head over there. Before we take down the stream as well, I want to share the latest numbers that we were able to get about this outbreak here in our state. So if you take a look at the big picture across Texas, there are now more than 4,600 positive cases here in our state. There are now 72 people who have died because of COVID-19. And at this point, more than 50,000 people have been tested for COVID-19 in Texas. Right here in our viewing area, this is just a breakdown of the counties that receive our signal from KXAN. So if you take a look there, the most populous counties, Hayes, Travis, and Williamson counties, have the most cases. And we only see those numbers keep climbing every day as the health agencies and health departments in those particular counties release those numbers. Looking directly at our most populous counties in our viewing area, Travis County now has more than 300 cases, and unfortunately, 3 people have died from COVID-19. Williamson County just announced that it has 63 confirmed positive cases and still 1 death there. And Hayes County has 42 confirmed cases. Those numbers, again, keep climbing every day as we track those and share them as well. I'm Will Dupree here in the KXAN live studio. We're going to take down this live stream. You can stay with us here on KXAN throughout the day for additional updates. We have that interview that the governor did with our Amanda Dugan during the noon newscast. It's being cut at the moment and will be posted on our website here very, very shortly. So please stay with us. We are still tracking everything and trying to provide as much information as we can Everyone, please stay safe, stay healthy. That's what we wish for you, and we hope you wish the same for us here because we're practicing those different guidelines here in our newsroom and in our workplace. Thank you all again for watching, and we'll see you back here another time.